Hello, my YouTube friends. I get more questions about audio problems than any other thing in OBS. Today, I want to walk you through how to connect all the different types of audio sources to your live stream. Microphones, games, and browser audio, and more. Plus, how to adjust them for the best quality. So let's get to it. If you're always looking for tools, tips, and tricks to help make you a better YouTuber, subscribe to the channel and click that bell so you don't miss any new content.
This video is sponsored by Restream.io. Restream.io is a platform.
Hey, honey, what are you doing in the studio?
I'm telling the audience about Restream.io.
What? Did you think I was gonna forget?
Well, it wouldn't be the first time.
Well, did you tell them that they can live stream to multiple social media platforms like Facebook and YouTube, Twitter, and Twitch all at the same time?
No, because you didn't give me a chance.
Well, did you tell them that they can also live stream with up to 10 guests on the same broadcast?
No, I didn't have a chance to get to that either.
Well, what have you been doing all this time?
Look, you know what? Just go to click the link down below, find out everything you need to know about Restream.io. It's something you're really going to love. Just click on it.
Do it. Let's get back to the video. Audio is tricky business in OBS. It can let you down big time, especially with inferior streaming equipment. And we're trying to make do with as little as possible, let's face it. So I'll start with the basics connecting the different types of audio to your OBS. A microphone is the most common OBS input. And on Windows and Mac, these are added totally different. When you add a camera on a Windows machine, it will always add a microphone. And you need to be sure you scroll down to the bottom and click the button to specify which microphone you want OBS to use. On a Mac, you add the microphone separately. And personally, I like this setup much better because I know there isn't any audio in the scene that I don't want. All you do is click the plus under sources, then click Audio Input Capture, give it a name you'll remember, and click OK. Select the microphone you want in the dropdown, and then click OK again. While we only have one audio source in here, let me show you how to adjust and set it up properly. You want to test the levels by speaking into the microphone and looking at the source in your audio mixer. You can adjust the sound levels up and down using the slider below the source, and you can mute the source by clicking on the speaker to the right. Right-click on the microphone in audio input, or click on the gear next to the input and select Advanced Audio Properties. In Advanced Audio Properties, there are three potential areas that you may need to tweak. The first is the volume, where you can adjust the microphone gain up and down depending upon the circumstances. The second is the sync offset. This is useful when you're using a microphone that's not directly connected to the camera source and there's a slight delay in your camera. You can delay your microphone audio to match the video. The third is the audio monitoring. This has three settings you need to know. The first is monitor off. This setting sends the microphone audio to the stream, but you won't hear it through your speakers or your headphones. This is usually the standard setting for your own microphone. It's really distracting in a live stream to hear your own voice on a slight delay. The next setting is monitor only mute output. This is a setting you would use for a source only you want to hear. Like a producer of your live stream or something, you can hear them, but it never goes out to the stream. The last setting here is monitor and output. This will play back your source to your output speakers or headphones and also broadcast it. You never want this one set unless you're wearing headphones. I use this setting for stream alerts like donations and stuff, so I can hear them in case I miss seeing the animation on the screen. That's all you need to know in Advanced Audio Properties, so let me show you some ways you can improve the sound quality. In the Sources window, right-click on your audio source and select Filters. Under Audio Filters, select Compressor. This brings up a list of settings that compress the sound waves. This will make sure that your highs don't peak and your lows are still audible. The next one will remove noise, and you have two choices here. Noise gate will turn your microphone on when you speak, but off when you aren't. This is perfect for game streams or guest interviews where there are other sounds filling the sound void between when you speak. This can be distracting without those other sounds though. Your microphone goes completely silent when you're not speaking, which is completely unnatural sounding and actually annoying to some. If it's just you without any background music or anything, I recommend using noise suppression instead. This will lower the noise floor but leave enough as to not be so distracting. We talked about these features on our microphone, but you can use them on any audio source. Let's talk about adding other audio sources to your stream. The most common other audio source is desktop audio. This is audio from your browser playing a video or guests on Restream or Zoom. On a Mac, this can be a complicated process of setting up a device to reroute the audio so you can capture it. Check this video out to see how you set it up. For Windows, you click the plus under Sources and select Audio Output Capture. Now select the device that plays your audio, speakers or headphones, and click OK. Now all the audio that would normally go to the speakers will be captured and sent to the live stream. This includes game audio, computer alerts, and any audio, so keep that in mind. The other common audio is from media sources like video or sound bites you may want to play on your stream. You just click the plus under sources and select media source to add them. If you have a question about an audio problem you're having, leave a comment and let me know. I answer everybody. You could also check out this video, which should help you solve the most common audio problems you're gonna run into. And if you're always looking for tools, tips, and tricks to help make you a better YouTuber, subscribe to the channel. My name is Michael Fire Jr. Thank you so much for watching. Have a great day, and I'll see you in the next one.